Kilani and I'm going to present a short talk on the invasiveness of Cytis ascoparias in relative in South Africa. Cytis ascoparias is commonly known as Ostrum and Ulex. Europeus is commonly known as Gauze. Both of these plants are legumes and they are from the family Fabaceae, and they can grow up to 4 meters tall. They are both native to Europe, but Ostrum is also native to Northern Africa. They have been found to be invading their habitat such as overgrazed pastures, bent forests, along roadside and in sand dunes. They have been also reported to be highly invasive in many countries, and they got introduced into these countries as garden ornamentals, hedge plants, and they also used to stabilize our environment. The reason that makes them to be highly invasive is due to the fact that they produce a high number of seeds, and their spread rate is actually very rapid. And that on establishment, they form a large thicket that's killing native plant species that are growing in association with them. We also have some populations in South Africa that got introduced from 1940s for Ostrum and 1930s for Gauze. However, empirical data on the invasiveness of these two plant species in South Africa is very scarce, and hence the rationale for undertaking this study. So what we wanted to actually determine the current and the potential distribution of both species in South Africa, and determine the population structure, reproductive capacity and output, and assess the effectiveness of herbicide use in the management of both plant species. So what I did is I did the individual counts of in all visited populations, and I also measured growth parameters such as height, stem diameter, and crown diameter. I also determined seed output in the selected population and collected seed bank data in Ostrum population. Still going to do that for Gauze as well. And at the moment, I have identified 17 populations of Ostrum and a total of 3 Gauze populations. The population size varied widely among populations of each species. And this slide here shows the size class frequency distribution for both species. And the first two graphs over there show the graphs for Ostrum, and the second row is for Gauze. Top graphs actually shows height versus the number of individuals per size class in terms of height, and the bottom one shows a number of individuals per size class in terms of crown diameter. And in all these cases, we actually observed that the frequency distribution was actually positively skewed, meaning that there were a high number of younger plants as compared to other plants. We also noted that the both species started to reproduce at a very young age. This first two graphs shows the size class at which both species, Ostrum species, started to reproduce in terms of height, and for the top graphs, and that one is for Gauze, and at the bottom we actually shown the minimum size at which both species started to reproduce in terms of crown diameter, and in all cases it shows that both species start to reproduce at a very young age. We noted that there was a high number of seeds produced per individual plant in both species, and we also noted that there was a very weak positive relationship between growth parameters such as height, crown diameter, and stem diameter in relation to the total number of seeds produced per individual plant. We also noted that there was a high seed bank load in Ostrum population that we visited, and so far I can conclude that both species seem to have a high potential to become invasive due to the fact that they produce high number of seeds and seedlings. Where the work is still going on, and I still need to do some seed bank studies for Gauze, pollination studies, and assess the efficacy of herbicide treatment, and then do some follow-ups on the growth experiment that are running at the moment. Thank you so much for that.